Hello and welcome to St. Paul's Cathedral. Thank you so much for joining us for our first concert with audience in quite a while. It's so lovely to have people back in this beautiful building for some live music. And we are so lucky to have Amir Farid here to perform for us today. St. Paul's Cathedral stands on the traditional lands of the Kulin Nation. We would like to pay our respects to elders past, present and emerging, and acknowledge any Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people here today or engaging with our live stream. We also recognise that the traditional owners of this land have been singing, dancing and telling stories here for over 2,000 generations, and today we are honoured to join with them and continue their tradition with our own music. Today, Amir will be performing Chopin and Mozart alongside Australian composers and Cawrse and Stuart Greenbaum. Stuart is here today and will hop up later on to talk to us about his piece, Iceman. You can find out more about Amir and the works performed today in your programs. And if you are watching online, you can download a program from the St. Paul's Cathedral website. Also in your programs is a list of our upcoming Wednesday lunchtime concerts, which will be starting back on February 3rd and running right throughout the year. We're very excited to have them back. We're going to bring you a variety of brilliant performers featuring instruments from voice and piano to violin, harp, saxophone and vibraphone. So there's something there for everyone, and we hope you'll be able to join us for some of these concerts this year. With a downturn in revenue due to the pandemic, your support in exchange for these concerts is most welcome. Please do pop a donation in the plate on your way out if you haven't already. And you are also able to make donations to the Cathedral's Music Foundation on the St. Paul's Cathedral website. Please do give generously and help us keep the music going. And without further ado, we hope that you enjoy today's performance by Amir Farid.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Can you hear me? Is this working? Do I have to turn it on? No, I don't know. Anyway, I'll just speak out like this. Can you all hear me like this? Great. That's okay, this is nice. As long as you can hear me. Thank you all, ladies and gentlemen, for coming. It's been a challenging year, or almost a year for most of us, all of us. For performers like myself, we had the privilege of being able to perform online without audiences, but this is what makes all the difference. So thank you for making the way here and making this that much more special for myself and hopefully for you as well. That was Chopin's Ballade No. 1 in G minor, one of four ballades that he wrote. And I thought about the theme for today's program, and isolation came to mind. The major work at the end of the program, Iceman by Stuart Greenbaum, will tie it all together. But Adam Mickiewicz, Polish poet, who wrote the poem which this work was based on, was in exile when he wrote the poem. And that brought a feeling of isolation in himself. And it comes through his poetry, and it sure comes through in Chopin's music. The next work by Australian composer Anne Cawrse is actually based on an opera that she has written called Innocence. And the inspiration for this opera is a novel, Time's Long Ruin, which is also the name of this work that I'm about to play. And it's about Adelaide suburban childhood and the loneliness that can be associated with that in the case of the author's story. And I thought this would be a very, very fitting work for this program as well. This is Time's Long Ruin by Adelaide-based composer Anne Cawrse.
Thank you.
1780s because of war with the Turks. Vienna was, well, not like Melbourne, but in that sense, Mozart was out of work. He wasn't getting commissions, he wasn't getting concerts. I bet he was feeling isolated. But that didn't stop him from composing, just like it didn't stop us from performing online and streaming. This work, the Adagio in B minor, it's one of his most striking works for piano because of its key. B minor is a very rare key for its day. There's only one other work that Mozart uses that key for, a chamber work from about 10 or 11 years earlier, I think. But it's a very dissonant key for its time because equal temperament wasn't a thing in those days, where every string on the piano is mathematically equal distance from each other in terms of frequency. So B minor in his day had a very harsh sound to it, a very dissonant sound to it. So it was reserved for real angst. And that's what this piece is. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you. for the ultimate story of isolation. Is Stuart in the room? Yes, can I invite Stuart to come forward, please, and talk about the next work? Stuart Greenbaum, please.
Well, it's such a delight to be here listening to the sublime playing of Amir Farid here on a sunny but cool afternoon in Melbourne. Beautiful playing. So, as to Iceman, it's written nearly half a lifetime ago. For me, it's in three movements. It's around half an hour long. James Scott was trekking with a friend in the Himalayan mountains in Nepal, and bad weather set in. They weren't really properly equipped for the conditions, but they didn't think that they thought the weather was going to be okay, and suddenly it wasn't. They got separated, and quite quickly he could barely see in front of his face. He was lost. He didn't know really where he was. He knew roughly where they were, but he didn't really know where he was. He was alone, cold, and everything all of a sudden felt very, very different. And that's where the music starts. From there, he finds a rocky outcrop, a ledge for shelter, and he hauls his backpack and himself under that and stays there for the night. And in actual fact, he stays there for the next 43 days, effectively without food. He has water, of course, because you can be surrounded by snow and ice, and you can do something with that. There were a few episodes where he heard a helicopter and ran out into the snow to try and wave it down unsuccessfully. There were other times where he just looked up at the moon on a really clear night and just thought the place was actually quite beautiful. Eventually he expected he'd die there, and after about 30 days he had a dream one night where he was back in Brisbane and he was talking with all of his friends and family, and he said the dream for the first time in 30 days he dreamt in colour. He had this dream of colour of being with his friends and family. And he woke up and everything was black and he felt that he'd given up. But eventually, of course, as if you've read the notes, or as you can imagine, he actually is found. It's his sister who keeps organising search parties in spite of everyone saying no one can survive these conditions. His sister believes he's alive, and eventually he's found, and the final section of the third movement is called Affinity. He has an affinity for his rock, and he says that even though he knew that he was in many ways imprisoned by the environment, he never lost his respect for the beauty and grandeur of his surroundings. So it's something of an epic journey piece. If you yourselves get lost in the program notes trying to work out what section you're up to, maybe just close your eyes and find your own journey. I'm sure Amir will take us through it beautifully. Thanks for listening.
Thank you.
Thank you.